I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
We are talking to one of the most brightest boxing stars on the planet, Shakur Stevenson. How are you feeling tonight?
I'm great.
All right, let's talk about some big fights that are coming up. So you have, of course, the big news. Deontay Wilder was really looking forward to fight Joshua, and now it looks like Joshua is fighting Povetkin. What do you say about that?
I didn't even know that they was fighting each other, but anybody that's fighting Wilder better be worried. Because Wilder hit hard.
And then we just saw Clarissa Shields have a tremendous win. Tell me what you saw in that fight.
I saw her bounce back like a true champion from that first round. And like I said before, I think she's the best female boxer ever.
Now, last time I saw you, you were ringside alongside the Errol Spence fight. What did you see in that fight?
Errol Spence looked like a monster. He couldn't do it with a body shot. He quit.
And then after the fight, you, AB, and Spence were hanging out. How was that? Adrien said that, what did he say? He posted you and he said, watch out for this guy.
Man, I just respect my big brother. Both of them, they my big brothers, and they understand that I'm the future of boxing.
Okay, Shakur, really quick. Spence Crawford, what do you think about that fight? You know both of them. You're friends with both of them.
You said what?
What do you think about Spence Crawford?
I think it's going to be a great fight. Terrence a hell of a boxer. Spence got power. Terrence got power too. Spence a good boxer also. So I don't know. It's whoever won it the most.
All right, a couple more and I'm done. Canelo Triple G 2. Who do you like on that one?
I got Canelo.
Why?
I feel like there's nothing Triple G could do differently. I feel like Canelo could adjust and box. Like he's a better boxer, so I feel like he could do a lot more.
What is next for you? Bob Arum said you are the new Sugar Ray Leonard.
Next, I'm not sure yet. I think I'm fighting in August. But I'm just ready to fight for a world title.
Already?
Yeah, already.
Who has the title in your division right now?
The person who got the belt that I want is Josh Warrington.
Would you go to UK to fight him, or does he have to come
here? Yes. I love the UK. I love England. England got the best boxing fans ever.
They do. They're lit. But you would go there, you would destroy, dethrone their champ and take his belt. But, hey, you got to do what you got to do.
Hey, don't England commentators ain't biased. I've been around them for a lot of my amateur career. They're not biased at all, so. I feel like they're going to keep it 100.
Okay, let's talk about Keyshawn Davis for a second. What can you tell us about him? He's doing great. You've been promoting him. You've been giving him shout-outs.
That's my little brother. That's one of the best amateurs in boxing right now. Man. I feel like, I feel like he cold. He cold.
All right.
He cold.
There you have a message to your fans who support you and love you. What do you tell them?
Keep tuning in and keep watching me. I'm the best young prospect in boxing, and I'm going to keep showing up.
All right. Really quick, who are you with?
I'm with a lot of real people. I'm with
real people.
One of the baddest men on the planet.
Oh, ABA, I heard you have a fight in September. Okay, don't tell anybody. How you been? How's life treating you?
Just know I'm going to get this money. Everybody about to be jealous of me.
AB, are you going to ghostwrite for some rap star?
Nah, I'm going to write for myself, but I will, though.
I saw that. What do you tell all your fans and supporters who are watching?
Hey, man, look, man, support me and I fight for you. You already know what it is. AB always balling. Elie Seckbach, my guy.
Report, yeah, I saw you were shopping with no shirt.
Yeah, Top. I do that sometimes.
It says no shirt, no service, but not in your case.
No, not in my case at all. I spent too much money. As you can see, I spent too much time at Gucci. You know what I'm saying? That's drip. That's called drip.
By the way, I talked to Jose Ramirez, the 140 WBC champ.
I beat his ass.
He'd like to fight you.
I beat his ass. I've been in a ring with him before. I beat his ass.
You'd like that fight for the belt?
I will beat his ass. I'm going to get all the belts.
And then, how's everything going with you in general? What's next for you? Are you working out already?
Listen, just know I'm still in some good shape. I'm feeling good. I'm looking better. And in September, I'm going crazy. And I'm getting big money.
But by the way, did you see Deontay Wilder took a page from your book today? Did you see his tweet about Joshua?
you know, I be teaching when I ain't even reaching. You know what I'm saying?
He said, Joshua, not only you smell like a pussy, you are a pussy. He was breaking it down to the level.
Hey, man, listen, man. People can say whatever they want, but when you watch me, man, I teach everybody something.
Tekashi 6'9", how would he do as a boxer?
He'd die.
Okay. Rick Ross, how would he do as a boxer?
He'd actually do kind of good because he can fight. He got a nice hook.
I saw you were working with him. Who do you want to see him fight for charity? If you could do one rapper against rapper. I mean, Snoop, would that be a good one? Drake?
Nah, him and Fatboy, SSE.
And he wins that one.
I got to roll with my big homie Ross.
There you have it. So, AB, really quick, Canelo Triple G 2, who do you like in the rematch?
I don't give a fuck about their career, man. I'm worried about Adrien the Problem, Broner Jr., everybody with about billions, my little brothers all across the world, Shakur, Stevenson, that's it.
Tell me about Shakur in Dallas, you, him, and Errol Spence. That's a trio.
Yeah, we had fun.
Do you think Spence will ever fight Crawford?
Yeah, that happened one time. You know, I think it needs more time to build up. You know, nowadays it's not like the old days where they build both fighters up and then they let them fight. Right now, they just want everybody to keep clashing heads, and I don't think it should go like that.
Now, Adrien, I recently stated, and I did numerous videos, that you are the most popular fighter in the U.S. today. Some people think that you're very popular, not only in boxing, but tell me a day in your life. What's it like? What did you do today?
Today, I got in at about 8:30, 9 o'clock this morning.
Miami.
Nah, I'm in Houston.
Oh, sorry. Okay.
And I just stayed up. I ain't get no sleep. Then Shakur got up. He came over and we went to the mall. We ate, went shopping, came back, and then went back to the mall, went shopping again, and then now we about to go have some fun.
That's it. All right. Make sure to follow Adrien Broner at Adrien Broner, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat. No, Snapchat is a different name.
Yeah, I don't. $1 billion AB?
Yeah, something like that. About billions. Are you going to be?
Adrien Billions.
Now, are you in touch with Robert Easter? How's he doing? How's the camp going for him?
He's doing great. He just, out the blue, I was thinking about him, and then out the blue, he texted me. He said, I love you, big bro. And I told him, I'll see him in a minute. I love you too, man. I'll be down there. Because we're going to actually go down there and work out with him for a couple of days and keep his spirits up and make sure he's working hard to push him.
Bob Arum said he'd like to see Amir Khan Crawford. Do you like that fight?
I love that fight. You know, that'd be a great fight for Crawford. That'd be another name on his resume. And I think Crawford would stop him.
Who would you want next? I mean, they're talking about a Jesse Vargas rematch. Everybody wants to fight you. You're down to fight anybody. You'd fight Wilder if they offered you to fight.
Damn right. Overhands all day.
Is there anyone you want to fight right now?
Man, listen. I do whatever's best for Adrien Broner at the point of my career. And, you know, I don't back down from no fight. And I ain't worried about no fighter. As long as my check right, man, we gonna have a hell of a night.
All right, David. And now, last thing, tell me about Shakur Stevenson. What do you think about him as a person, as a fighter?
To me, he's like the little brother, the kid. Sometimes he get on your nerves, but at the end of the day, he's all fun and games. He's still learning. He's still growing. And you know, I love him when he's around me, man. I could teach him so much, and he's just a good kid. He's a good kid with a great spirit.
Did you see Clarissa Shields fight by any chance?
Yeah, I seen it.
What did you think? She brought it.
Yeah, of course. She fought her ass off, man. She showed people that she's a warrior. She brought that Detroit heart in there, and she fought it in, and she won.
All right, there you have it, Adrien Broner. Shout out again to all your fans if they're watching. Make sure to follow you on Instagram. You have the most lit Instagram online right now. Everybody tunes in whether they love you or hate you.
Yeah, that shit going crazy. I might put some up today. I don't know, man. I was thinking about putting some up today. I might.
Everybody pays it. You must get crazy text messages and phone calls every time you post something.
Yeah, I do. I don't be answering all of them, though. I try, but it be getting annoying sometimes.
Have you been talking to Tank? He's expecting a baby.
I know. I talk to him all the time, every day.
What's a good fight for Tank right now? He just won the title again. What was that? Sanctioned
by... I always tell him, man, just keep building your record, man. Don't be... falling into that bullshit, man. Just keep building your record, man.
All right, so Eddie Hearn offered you $2.5 million. That wasn't, he doesn't know how much money you really make. You said you're...
only if they knew.
Would he have to add a zero or another number from $2 million, like to $20 million? Because was it Rock Nation was $30 million or 60?
Man, listen to me, man. Eddie Hearn, I mean, he's a good guy and all, but them numbers weren't right. Like Ross was saying...
But everything's good, so there you have it. Adrien Broner smiling, he's in Houston, Shakur Stevenson, and we'll be back for more. So hopefully they announce your fight soon.
All right, I love you, man.
All right, last thing I gotta ask you, they're gonna announce this for August 4th, Brandon Rios, Victor Ortiz. What do you think?
I already knew that was gonna happen.
What do you think about the fight itself?
I know a lot that people don't know about boxing. I don't know.
Okay, Devin Alexander, who you know, against Bruto, who you know, they're fighting on the undercard of Mikey Robert Easter.
This one I got to get on the phone off.
Okay, there you have it. Adrien Broner, stay tuned. Thank you so much always for your time. We appreciate it. For ESNewsReporting.com, Seckbach reporting. So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Elie Seckbach.